So work on Tesla's Giga Berlin can now finally be continued. Very good. Because as you can imagine, this whole incident has made us very, very angry. We of course have a theory what was really going on. On the surface, some crazy environmentalist groups were behind this. However, this runs much deeper.
Then the Model S has increased in range, reaching now almost 400 miles. And Tesla has made a deal with CATL, which is an important step towards cobalt-free batteries. And what other disruptive stuff is happening? Oh yeah, let's talk about the next city which will have autonomous shuttle pods. San Francisco? New York? Tokyo? Shanghai? No! So stay tuned for these highly interesting disruptive developments.
So finally, the work at Tesla's future Gigafactory site in Grünheide near Berlin in Germany could continue. As many of you already know, a court order from the Brandenburg state orders the stop of tree felling activities. Tesla was already well advancing to fell the trees, and over half of the area was already cleared when surprisingly this court order came on the 16th of February. You can imagine our reaction when we read the news on that day. Total disbelief. And of course, you can imagine how I reacted. So the court order came after an official complaint from two overzealous so-called environmentalist groups who filed for a stop of tree felling activities. Those two groups are just crazy in our opinion, because what they did has nothing to do with environmentalism. So one group is called the Green League of Brandenburg, and the other one is called translated Association for Landscape Care and Protection of Wildlife in Bavaria. Wait, Bavaria? So what does Bavaria have to do with the Gigafactory near Berlin? Well, absolutely nothing. However, German law permits any association to file an official complaint at court, and the court has to take the time to really evaluate the validity of the claims. Welcome to German bureaucracy. We are of course quite suspicious why a Bavarian association should file a complaint for Brandenburg. So who would profit from hindering Tesla's Giga Berlin progress? Oh yeah, some old car makers could really profit a lot from hindering Tesla, right? And who is in Bavaria? BMW, of course, and also Audi. It's not a far stretch to imagine that the Bavarian Association received some backing from BMW lawyers.
Now this is just our theory, so please take it with a grain of salt, but we can really imagine that BMW would have absolutely liked to hinder or completely foil Tesla's plans to build a Giga Berlin. Since BMW knows full well what will happen to them if Tesla pours out hundreds of thousands of much cheaper Model 3s and Model Ys already by 2021. They know full well the massive impact these Teslas will have on their sales numbers, because they have nothing, really nothing, which can even remotely come close to Teslas regarding range, regarding charging network, and regarding the autopilot self-driving functionality. Now this is just our theory, and we might of course be wrong, and it could really just be the insane short-sightedness and stupidity of overzealous and stupid so-called environmentalist groups, who in our opinion are not real environmentalists. They are just against everything new. New? Bad. So it could really be that there actually is no conspiracy, and that all this can be actually explained by their absolute stupidity. Because Tesla said they will replant all the trees threefold, three times more than before. Oh, and this is not a natural forest, by the way, but a monoculture of trees which were planted for being felled for paper and cardboard anyways. So we probably might never know with 100% certainty who is actually behind this, but we are just extremely glad that reason and logic has prevailed this time. Because if not, Germany would have become the laughing stock of the world. It already is in some regards, unfortunately. Now, already now we often criticize Germany for its angst of new things, for its fear of new technology, for its technology-unfriendly environment, its outright backwardedness in many regards. In many places in Bavaria, you cannot even pay with credit card. You have to use old-fashioned money, like cash, you know, coins, like in the freaking Middle Ages. Oh, and buildings in Munich haven't been permitted to be higher than 100 meters since 2004. Just so that you know what level of backwardedness we are dealing with here. Now, Germany actually once used to be a hub of innovation and science in the late 19th and early 20th century. Not so much anymore, as we can unfortunately see. It has been hijacked by an overburdened, extreme bureaucracy, like insane bureaucracy, and an absolute Kleingeist thinking.
And Tesla not having been allowed to build Giga Berlin would have been such a serious blow of insane proportions to the German economy and to the future of Germany as a hub of technological innovation. So we are extremely glad that this has been averted now, in no small part because of the vocal support of high-ranking politicians for Giga Berlin, such as the CDU Minister of Brandenburg, Jörg Steinbach. Even the quite radical Green Party massively criticized those two environmentalist groups, saying, "You don't always have to be against everything." So if even they are siding with Tesla, then you really know that even German politicians know full well how important Giga Berlin is for the future of Germany. Of course, the players behind the court filing are not very happy with this outcome. They certainly hoped that they would be able to prevent Giga Berlin from being built. We can imagine the mood at their headquarters might be something like this now.
Im Süden hat der Gegner Zossen genommen und stößt auf Stahnsdorf vor. Der Feind operiert jetzt am nördlichen Stadtrand zwischen Frohnau und Pankow. Und im Osten ist der Feind bis zur Linie Lichtenberg-Mahlsdorf-Karlshorst gelangt.
Mit dem Angriff Steiners wird das alles in Ordnung kommen.
Mein Führer, Steiner...
Steiner konnte nicht genügend Kräfte für einen Angriff massieren. Der Angriff Steiner ist nicht erfolgt.
Das war ein Befehl! Der Angriff Steiners war ein Befehl! Wer schickt Sie?
Das hier ist Magen! Sie meinen Befehl zu widersetzen!
Jeder hat mich belogen, sogar die SS! Die gesamte Generalität ist nichts weiter als ein Haufen niederträchtiger, treuloser Feiglinge!
Mein Führer, ich kann nicht zulassen, dass die Soldaten, die für Sie verbluten...
Ist das Feiglinge! Verräter und Versager! Die Generalität ist das Geschmeiß des deutschen Volkes! Sie ist ohne Ehre! Und doch habe ich allein auf mich gestellt, ganz Europa erobert. Von allem Anfang an bin ich so verraten und betrogen worden. Es wurde ein ungeheurer Verrat geübt am deutschen Volke. Aber alle diese Verräter werden bezahlen. Mit ihrem eigenen Blut werden sie bezahlen.
Der Krieg ist verloren. Aber wenn Sie, meine Herren, glauben, dass ich deswegen Berlin verlasse, irren Sie sich gewaltig. Eher jage ich mir eine Kugel durch den Kopf. Tun Sie, was Sie wollen.
Okay, that one had to be. Sorry, I was waiting for this opportunity since, I don't know. In any case, we are now extremely happy that the Tesla Gigafactory at Berlin is now allowed to progress further. This is an excellent development for Germany, for the German economy, for Tesla, of course, and for the whole world, for everyone, actually. Now, last week we didn't talk about some amazing developments at Tesla because we were talking a lot about flying air taxis and the Hyperloop in this video, which you can watch right here. So we therefore didn't mention that the Model S is now nearing an amazing range of almost 400 miles in the latest iteration. The Model S Long Range Plus, as it's now called, has an official EPA rating of 390 miles or 630 kilometers. The Model X also got a boost to 351 miles. Oh, and according to a new discovery made in Tesla's latest battery management system firmware, it won't be long until Model S and X will be upgraded to a 110 kWh battery pack, so that the range of the Model S will be quite above 400 miles in the near future. Now, we don't see any other car maker coming near to that range anytime soon. Sorry to say this, but a range of over 400 miles with only a 110 kWh battery pack, that is an insane degree of efficiency. Remember please that, for example, the Audi e-tron has a 90 kWh battery pack, but only an EPA range of 204 miles.
The Porsche Taycan even has a 93.4 kWh battery and only a range of 201 miles for the turbo version, even slightly less for the Turbo S version. So the efficiency of other electric cars is just so insanely bad compared to Tesla. Those cars would need a 200 kWh battery pack in order to get the same range as Tesla is getting now with half of that battery size. That's how amazingly efficient Tesla cars are. That's why we are absolutely sure that the lead of Tesla will just keep increasing in the next years. And the gap between Tesla and the competition will actually grow, not decrease. Other car makers should just give up on their EV efforts and license Tesla technology to produce their cars. And the smarter ones will probably do exactly that. But pride, of course. Pride always gets in the way. Besides the efficiency and many other excellent developments at Tesla, such as the solar roof ramp-up, we are glad to see that a new deal with CATL from China has been made. So future China-made Teslas will have batteries supplied by CATL, the largest Chinese battery manufacturer. But what's really cool about that is that these batteries will be cobalt-free. One of the major criticisms we often heard against electric cars was that lithium-ion batteries need cobalt, which is sometimes being extracted in cobalt mines under very bad conditions, for example, involving child labor. Of course, many big oil-sponsored news media sites immediately used this argument for their anti-Tesla, anti-electric car fad narrative, painting the picture of thousands of children having to work in the mines in the Congo so that we can have electric cars, which is total BS, of course. The vast majority of cobalt is a byproduct of copper and nickel mining. Copper and nickel mines are really absolutely standard, and no child labor is happening there. We talked about that in this video here, where we tried to bust the most common anti-electric car fake news. Anyways, the percentage of cobalt in Tesla's batteries was only 3% since quite a while now, and even tweeted that it will drop down to zero. So soon, Tesla batteries will be completely free of cobalt. The CATL batteries for China will already be cobalt-free. But this will also be the case worldwide at some point in the next few years, we assume. So this is an excellent development, destroying one of the last arguments against electric cars one could come up with.
Now let's take a look at another disruption which is happening. We all know that self-driving cars are coming and that they will completely change the way we commute to and from work. The self-driving robotaxi fleet of Tesla, for example, will be a total game changer. But more and more companies are now starting to build autonomous shuttle pods. Only a few weeks ago, GM revealed their autonomous shuttle pod for a ride-sharing service in San Francisco, about which we talked in this video here. And now Jaguar and Land Rover unveiled their autonomous shuttle pod. And in which city will they be driving around already next year? Shanghai? Tokyo? Seoul? No! Coventry! Now, no offense to anyone living in Coventry, it's certainly a beautiful city, but it wouldn't have been the first city coming to our mind when we would have thought about high-tech autonomous shuttle pods roaming the streets. But this is actually where we'll see the autonomous shuttle pods drive around already as soon as 2021 as part of a ride-sharing service. Now, the interior is accessed via dual center opening sliding doors on one side, and four individual seats are mounted on tracks that are shown facing in the same direction. But Jaguar and Land Rover also say the vehicle can be adapted for delivery use by removing the seats. Now, the pods currently still only are autonomous ready, so they still have a steering wheel and pedals, but they will be updated for autonomy in the near future as soon as it will be technologically possible. So soon, we'll see driverless delivery robots in Houston, autonomous shuttle pods in San Francisco, and then also in Coventry. We have to say the future that was being promised to us as kids is now coming along nicely. Okay, there was a bit of a delay, but fortunately now it really is happening. So what do you think? Who is behind this court order to stop Tesla at the Giga Berlin? Some lawyers from German carmakers or just some totally crazy so-called environmentalists?
And what do you say to Tesla's new deal with CATL from China? And when do you think that all Tesla batteries worldwide will become cobalt-free?
So now you have just watched the JS Disruption Report hosted by Jixuan and Sebastian.
Every Wednesday. So this is our commentary show on the latest developments at Tesla, electric cars, and also other disruptive techs.
So see you on the next show, and then I would say, auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen.